courts, we the jury find the defendant, Kyle H. Rittenhouse, not guilty.
Members of the jury, are these your unanimous verdicts? Is there anyone who does not agree with the verdicts as read? Would you wish the jury polled?
No.
Okay. Okay, folks, your job is done, and we started just about 3 weeks ago. And I told you it could last 2 weeks and 2 days. This is 2 weeks. This is 3 weeks. You were.
Constitution is the law in this country. If you don't like it, put those people in and never come back.
What's up and welcome to My Point of View. I am your fat and opinionated host, and let me preface this video by saying that I know that for some reason this trial has been really divisive, and the media has gone out of its way to divide people over this trial. And I want everyone to always feel welcome on any of my channels, because there's a lot of talk about diversity in this country, but no one wants to talk about diversity of opinion. I welcome diversity of opinion on all of my channels, and none of your opinions have to line up with mine. So right now, I'm not here to talk about whether I agree with this verdict or I don't agree with this verdict. I am just here to report the news, and the news is that Kyle Rittenhouse has been found not guilty on all charges. But what I am worried about is the aftermath of all this and what comes next. Because what I will say about this trial is I don't like how some of the things were handled in this trial. For one, I don't know how fair a trial can be when you have people outside of the courthouse threatening to, you know, threatening harm to the jurors and the judge and the people involved. I know that MSNBC was actually trying to track down the jurors and report their names. Like, it's gotten really crazy around this trial. And you can tell that a lot of it is the media trying to add fuel to the fire. And I believe that's what's gonna happen in Kenosha tonight. The media is gonna do whatever they can to add fuel to this fire until Kenosha burns once again. So my main real point of making this video is I know that a lot of my subscribers live in this area and live around this area, and I would just urge y'all to be safe and be careful. I don't care if you agree with the verdict or you don't agree with the verdict. Be safe and be careful, because I can only imagine that there's gonna be some craziness coming out of this. We've already seen all of the threats online. We knew from the beginning that if they found Kyle not guilty, that a certain portion of America was gonna go crazy, you know, and they're gonna do the same things they were doing last summer with the riots and what have you. And I just want everyone to be safe. Let's try not to have another situation like what happened with Kyle Rittenhouse, you know? But it's a recipe for disaster, and that's basically what they're cooking up tonight. They're gonna be cooking up more Kyle Rittenhouse situations tonight and in the coming days because of this verdict. Now, like I said, I don't care if you agree with the verdict or not. My main issue is we all need to be humane here. And I don't think that if you disagree with the verdict that you going down and burning or going out and burning small businesses is gonna help anything. Just like it didn't help anything last summer. Okay? And I pray for everyone that lives in this area, especially the older people, the people who've been here for a long time. You know, I have a lot of respect for small business owners, and I know how hard it is. And it saddens me when I see businesses destroyed and stuff like that, because I know the work that goes into that. And I know that people think that property damage means nothing and things like that. And why do you value property over human lives? I don't value property over human lives. But at the same time, I'm not gonna act like going and burning down some person's business who has nothing to do with anything is an appropriate response to whatever is going on in this country. So all I know is he was found not guilty. I'm assuming that they're gonna take him as far away as possible, because there are threats out there. And I'm assuming that we're gonna see a lot of crazy scenes coming out of Kenosha and other cities around America today and in the coming days. And I plan on covering those crazy scenes right here on this channel. So go ahead and hit subscribe, go ahead and hit that notification bell, and we will dive into the social aspect of things and how people react to this verdict. But for now, drop your opinions about this down in the comments below. Once again, like I said, all opinions are welcome here. Regardless of how you feel, all opinions are welcome here. As long as you have my best interests at heart and I have your best interests at heart, we can work through all of the disagreements. But drop your opinions down in the comments below. While you're down there, hit that thumbs up button, hit that subscribe button, ring that notification bell. And as always, remain opinionated.